I want to modify the layout of a B-spline, but the length of the B-spline should not change. I can modify it by double-click on it in Draft Workbench, and then I can move such a control point somewhere. Okay, the base for the B-spline is a D-wire. I delete the B-spline, and now I want to move this point. So, and I say I only want to move this point inside of this rectangle. So I calculate isolines where I can put this point for a given length of the B-spline. This is a small script. I select for this case the point I want to change and the rectangle. The vertex and rectangle is selected and I run the script. And now there are some isolines computed. And when I go here, I see this is a set of points. When I move the inner point of the B spline onto this line, then the B spline will have length 850. So I can display the length of my B spline. At the moment it's 907. So, and now we want to move this point. I go to edit mode and now I select this point and move it here. And this is isoline 850, and I display the length 850. So I can repeat this once more. I move this time the point from here to this dark line and close it. And now the question is, what marks this dark line? I select it and I see it's 980. And now I display the length of my curve, 980. So this procedure works on other control points and with other rectangles too. So in the next case, I select this point and the other rectangle. I restart the calculation. And now I get an environment which helps me to move the point here. So calculation has finished. We again start edit mode. This pole I move to this blue isoline. Okay, so the blue isoline is here. It has the length 970 and I display the length of the B spline is 968. So I have here intervals of 10, so this is inside precision. For any length, I have here a isoline and I only have to drag and drop the control point, the interpolation point of the B spline on such a curve, and then the B spline has exactly the length given here.